This is the first phone with the Snapdragon 8s Gen 3. Yes, this is the Xiaomi Civi 4. It launched in China about a month ago and we had to get it because we wanted to see what this new processor offers. But after running the benchmarks and testing the performance of the phone, the Snapdragon 8s Gen 3 is not what you think it is. It's completely different. Let me explain. First of all, we need to understand why Qualcomm needed a new processor. See, the 7 Gen 3 and 7 Plus Gen 3 cover the mid-range market and the 8 Gen 3 covers the flagship segment. So Qualcomm needed a chipset for a phone in the affordable flagship segment, you know, the 40 to 50,000 price range where you normally find phones with last year's flagship chipset. That's where the Snapdragon 8s Gen 3 is supposed to come in. Okay, so if we take a look at the Snapdragon 8s Gen 3's core setup, we get one Cortex X4 Prime core clocked at 3 GHz, four Cortex A720 performance cores clocked at 2.8 GHz, and three Cortex A520 efficiency cores clocked at 2 GHz. In comparison, these are the core setups of the Snapdragon 8 Gen 3 and the 7 Plus Gen 3. And as you can see, the setup of the 8s Gen 3 is exactly the same as the 7 Plus Gen 3. So it's basically a higher clocked version of the 7 Plus Gen 3 processor and not an underclocked version of the flagship 8 Gen 3. Now, apart from the core setups, here are all the differences between the 8s Gen 3, 8 Gen 3 and 7 Plus Gen 3. So you can see what's changed here and what remains basically the same. We also ran some benchmarks on this phone and if you look at the scores, the 8s Gen 3 performs slightly better in most cases than the 7 Plus Gen 3 and is similar to 8 Gen 2 but not anywhere near the 8 Gen 3 obviously. In AnTuTu in fact, it scores worse than the 7 Plus Gen 3 but that could be due to the thermals of the Civi 4 Pro because the phone was reaching 48 to 50 degrees when we ran the benchmarks. We could not run 3D Mark on this phone because it just doesn't work on Chinese phones with HyperOS. We also did the CPU throttling test and the 8s Gen 3 performs really well here, throttling to only 94% of its peak performance just like the 8 Gen 3, which is impressive when compared to the 7 Plus Gen 3 or the 8 Gen 2's throttling results. The point is, 8s Gen 3 is basically a marketing term. It is supposed to come to India in phones like the Poco F6, but by calling it an 8s, Qualcomm makes it seem like an 8 series processor that should perform at almost the same level as an 8 Gen 3 or Dimensity 9300. However, that's clearly not the case. It's basically a 7 Plus Gen 3 with a slightly boosted clock speeds and a better GPU. In fact, this should have been called a 7 Plus Gen 3 Pro or 7 Plus Gen 3 Pro Plus or something, but it's definitely not an 8 series chipset. If we keep the name aside for a bit, the new processor is definitely capable. In real world performance, the 8s Gen 3 holds up really well, and in gaming, it performs almost the same as the 8 Gen 3 or the 7 Plus Gen 3, be it in BGMI, where it supports Ultra HDR plus Ultra graphics and 60fps in Smooth plus Extreme mode, or in Genshin Impact, where it gets 60fps at highest settings. And if you're wondering, this phone doesn't support 90fps in BGMI, and that may be because the phone hasn't launched in India. Anyway, you do see a slight difference in the performance in COD Mobile, where the Snapdragon 8 Gen 3 performs a tad better than the 8s Gen 3, but it's quite close in everything else. So yeah, it's clearly a capable chipset. Look, it's just a matter of naming. I mean, if Qualcomm stuck with a name like 7 Gen 3 Pro, it would have still felt like a mid-range processor in a more expensive phone. In fact, this happened with Snapdragon 7 Plus Gen 2 that came in India in just one phone, the Poco F5, while all the other manufacturers stuck with 8 Plus Gen 1 as their choice of chipset because more and more users want 8 series processors in their phone. This year, by calling this chipset an 8s Gen 3, they have made it sound more like a flagship chipset, even though it's just an overclocked Snapdragon 7 series chipset. Therefore, a lot of people are likely to accept this chipset in a 40 to 50,000 range smartphone. So is this misleading or just good packaging? Tell us in comments. Subscribe to our channel if you want to watch more amazing tech videos like this one. Thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next one.